Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you IEEE 754 single precision floating point representation. That is also referred as IEEE 754 32 bits of format with floating point representation. So here I will explain you this IEEE 754 single precision format along with examples, so that will give you more clarity. So first of all, you need to understand how basic format is there with IEEE 754 single precision standard. Right, so that format includes 32 bits. Out of 32 bits, first bit that explains you sign. So here you see this first bit that explains you sign, right? And after that you'll be having another 8 bits with exponent, and this exponent will be bias exponent, that you can say. And after that you'll be having 23 bits of mantissa. So basically there will be three fields. First bit, that will be sine bit. Second will be bias exponent, and third is mantissa, right? If you see my previous video, in that I have explained you how to have normalization of floating point number, right? In that you see how to normalize that. So first of all, minus 1 to the power, that will be representing sine. Then 1 point something, that will be mantissa, and into 2 to the power something, that is exponent. So that is what we have done in terms of normalization in my previous video, right? Now based on that, this format is there. In that you see first bit, that will be representing sine. Now this is bias exponent. So bias exponent, as if you want to calculate this, then you'll be observing that will be, let us say it is BEE in short, that will be equal to exponent plus 127, right? So here, my dear students, when you want to calculate bias exponent at a time, first of all, you'll have to identify exponent, right? Plus 127, that will be bias exponent over here. And mantissa, that will be as per 1 point something, that something will be mantissa. Let me explain you that by one example, so that will give you more clarity. So here, for example, let us consider one case of one decimal number, right? And let us say that is 76.125 in decimal. So first of all, my dear students, as if number is given in decimal, you will have to convert that into binary, right? Now here you see 76.125, that is how it is there. So first of all, 76, that we need to convert. So to convert 76, all you need to do is you will have to divide that with respect to 2. So 76 divided by 2, that will be 38, and remainder is 0 over here. 38 divided by 2, that will be 19. And remainder is 0 over here. 19 divided by 2, that will be 9, and remainder 1 over here. 9 by 2, that will be 4, remainder 1 over here. 4 by 2, 2, remainder 0 over here. 2 by 2, that will be 1, and remainder 0 over here. So here, my dear students, you will have to see numbers in this direction, right? So here you see 76.125 in decimal, that will be now 76 that we have converted. So first you'll have to write 1, then 0, then this 0, then double 1, then double 0. That is how 76 that we have converted, right? Then after, fractional values will be there. So how to convert that fractional values? So for that, my dear students, here you see 0.125 is there, into 2 that you need to do. So 0.125 into 2, that is 0.25. Now you see 0.25 is there. So this 0 that I need to write over here. Then 0.25 into 2. So that is 0.5. Now again 0.5 is there. So I need to write 0 here. 0.5 into 2. So that is 1.0. So here now we are having 1. Now 0.0 into 2. That we need to do, but 0.0 into 2, that will be 0 always. So you don't need to write anything from here. Now in this, you'll have to note down the digits in this direction. So 0, 0, 1. So here I need to write 0, 0, 1, right? So now I'm having this binary equivalent of this decimal data, right? Now, my dear students, very essential point, that is normalization. Right, I have already explained that in my previous video, but still in this video also, I'll explain you how to normalize this binary number. So first of all, we need to normalize this binary number. So how to normalize this? So this number, you see that is positive. So minus 1 to the power 0 that I need to write. Minus 1 to the power 0 means positive number. Minus 1 to the power 1 means negative number. So minus 1 to the power 0 that I need to write. Then into 1 point something that I need to write. 1 point something, that something is mantissa, right? So 1 point something that I need to write. So see 1001100001, that is how it is there. So 1.00110001 that I need to write. Now, how many bits that we are shifting over here? So you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So towards left side we are shifting it, right? So you can say 2 to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 2 to the power 6, right? So the 6 is my exponent. So let me note down those digits. You see this 0, that is my sign over here. After 1 point something, we are having mantissa over here, right? And this 6, that is my exponent over here, right? Now we are having this. We can represent this now in form of this IEEE 754 single precision format in that first bit, that is sign bit. So let me explain you how to represent that. You see first bit, that is sign bit. So first is sign bit, let us write that as S, that is 0 over here. Then bias exponent that we have. You see exponent is 6, but bias exponent that is 127 plus 6, so that is 133. And that is what I need to represent in 8 bits, right? So how to have that in 8 bits? You see 133. So here, let me write that as per basic calculation. So you see how to represent that. 1, then 2, then 4, then 8, then 16, 32, 64, and 128, right? That is how it will be there. So to have 133, what we need to have over here? 128, that will be having 1 over here. Then you see 64, that will be having 0, 32 will be having 0, 16 will be having 0, 8 will be having 0, right? Now 4, that will be making it to 128 plus 4, that will be 132. 132 plus 1, that will be 133. That is how 8 bit that we can represent over here, right? Now next is mantissa. So you should know, my dear students, mantissa, that is having size of 23 bits in IEEE 754 single precision standard. Now you see here we are having this mantissa. So that is 0011, then 0000, then 1, and then zeros will be padded, right? So here I am not writing that many zeros, but you can say in total 23 bits will be there. So rest of the bits, that will be 0 over here, right? So this is how we can directly convert any number into IEEE 754 single precision standard. Here, my dear students, I have seen many questions that is coming in competitive examination as well. So in future coming videos, I'll be making examples video based on this that will give you more clarity regarding how exactly we can use this. Still, if anything that you would like to share it with me, please note it down in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.